another one, and another one.
He sees powerhouse now. Okay, get it right. Francis Powerhouse, the man right here.
How you doing,
Steve?
How you
doing? Good, good.
You think
all right? Yeah.
You ready to hit it?
Good,
man.
Ready.
It's good, man.
Yes.
Have a good workout.
Thank you.
What's up, guys?
Hey, Steve. How you doing, buddy?
How are you?
See you, man.
You all right?
Yeah, I can't complain.
How you doing?
Thanks for being here. Steve.
No problem. Got the whole crew, huh? Broke out here and just made this just circuit training and abs. And in this room, my friend Derek Pan's a three-time world kickboxing champion. He's got an MMA studio. It's going to be a cage in here. It's going to be all mixed martial arts. He's got a whole bunch of world champion grapplers in there, too. And then just for the regular members that don't want to go in there, we got bags. And actually, just put speed bags up now, too. July 1st. Switch July 1st from Goals to Powerhouse. Very happy to be with Powerhouse. Establishes are real nice people. They're great people. Should have been there from the beginning, really. Gold's Gym has got different owners now, and they're going in a different direction, and I want to stay in the direction that we're in, and I'm real happy to be with Powerhouse and where I am now.
That's the start. Flat dumbbell press. Quick, fast. With the quick, fast. Still is nice and heavy, okay? I feel like going heavy today. Mike Gray and Michael Duncan. Basically, set for set on the. I know Victor Munoz right here.
Hi, how's everybody doing? My name is Victor Martinez, New York's very own. Well, nah, it's Caprice Murray too, but you know what I mean.
Let's see how I feel as I go along, you know. And premeditate, you know, change. I didn't count that first one, all right? I mean, I don't bullshit too much when I train, so if you don't get much out of me, it's because that's how I am, okay?
The Olympia is about 3 weeks away. Today we'll be doing chest on the road to the Olympia. Make it a hard workout, no less intense than any other workout. It's gonna be tough, it's been a tough road. It's been a tough year, as you've seen. My placings haven't been up to par. But that's just, you know, just as good as your next show in bodybuilding. And this is my next show, and it will be good. It is the Olympia. It is the Super Bowl of bodybuilding, and I'm looking so much forward to it, more than ever. I mean, just as much as the first time. I take it as it comes, just like the first time. Enjoy the first time every single time, because the opportunity of being the Mr. Olympia stage is just uncomparable to anything else. It's just the feeling of it, just knowing that it's getting closer, it just sets more fuel into your body. You know, they have this new restrictions for the men. I won't mention anything about the women, but the men have to come in with that classical V-taper, no more bloatiness. I mean, that should have been bodybuilding from the get-go. I guess they lost track of it, and it's great that they're coming back to it, and they lost light of it, but as long as they're shining the light on it now again, it's great. I started my diet about 12 weeks ago. By the time I finish in 3 weeks, it'll be about a 15-week diet. My weight right now is about 260. I'm looking at competing in the high 240s, mid 240s. Definitely my condition has been the factor in order to placing high. I look forward to it. Just the motivation of it all, and just, you know, in these other shows that I've done, like I've mentioned, you know, the condition wasn't there, but there's always mishaps. They do happen. And hopefully this time I got it down packed to the T. You know, my diet did change a little. The way I train, more cardio definitely added. I'll be doing cardio at the end of this workout. And basically that's it. Let's go for it. I'm working with Chris Acedo, Gino Sylvain from Genetics. People like to say things, you know, like maybe Chris doesn't know how to work with me and stuff like that. They keep bringing up Night of Champions, but I like to tell everybody, forget Night of Champions. That was 3 years ago. You know, new time, new era, new show, a new feeling, and a new drive within me. So definitely love working with him. We make a great team. You know, as far as my diet goes, you'll see it on stage, the results. I'd say about 3,500 calories a day. Yeah, mostly protein, I would say. Right now, I'm still eating fish, just not as many meals. I'm eating maybe 1 to 2 meals of fish. I found out by me eating too much fish, will either get me too stringy, or it didn't make me hold on to the quality muscle that I needed, and therefore making me look flat and definitely not great looking, you know? So the whole fish deal has definitely changed. I go by what I like to eat, you know, the kind of fish I like to eat, the kind of way I like to eat it, the time of day I like to eat it. So definitely I'm not going fish crazy, you know, all these 5-6 meals of fish. I think it's just absurd, you know, to do it that way. It worked out great when I was younger, but my body has changed, and I do need more of a stronger kind of protein for my body to hold. So I definitely did change that, and my carb intake has been to a minimum. As you can see, my energy's up, and I'm only eating about 1 carb meal a day, and it's just the energy. People ask me, where does it come from? And it's just the drive to doing the best show in the world, the drive to do the Mr. Olympia. Okay. Low, I'm doing about maybe 60 grams a day of carbs. It's cool, I don't mind. It gives you a little high feeling. Just take the high feeling and convert it into positive energy. Fat count, I'm sorry I didn't do my homework, so I don't know my fat count right now, but it is pretty low. Yeah, I take flaxseed oil, definitely flaxseed oil, and the fish has the fat in it, and the chicken, but no extra fat as far as peanut butter or anything of that sort.
so much fun. That's it. This show, it's gonna be a great show. Just like always, I'm sure. I mean, watching it as a spectator, totally different. I mean, now it's just, I mean, it's not fun in games. People say have fun, but you know what I mean? I mean, fun is something different. This is serious. This is one in a lifetime. And, you know, I don't know where you get fun from. The aftermath is fun. You know, but just, you know, people say have fun. It's not a joke. No, it's not a joke. It's only one Mr. Olympia per year. Unless you keep on repeating it, you know? Some low chest work. So I think I'll combine these last two. Also add pullovers for the end. So I'll do some decline, some cable crossovers. Don't want to leave any angle out from the chest area, you know? Thank you. Hey, this is Ronnie Coleman approval, right? you don't get mad, you know? I have a shirt on over here. This is for you. That's why. For you. Alright, it's gonna be the last round over here. And then we'll pull overs. Yeah. Same time. I saw Lee Haney's chest when they had Muscle and Fitness. They have all the Olympians lined up. And they had Lee Haney's, the only one with the big upper chest. I was like, man, I want that. You know? So read a couple of his articles. I saw he emphasized a lot of incline. And I always started at least with two incline exercises. I always alternate. So today I do one incline. Next time I do chest, I do two incline exercises. Usually a fly dumbbell and an incline press. So this I might stick to Smith. Your body's smart, you'll get used to it. So I don't know if you change it. But definitely incline flies, not just incline presses. You gotta have those flies there too for your upper chest. Old school. Add a little delt work, so might do just a couple of rear delt sets. You know, just always do that with chest, and so I felt over the years my weakest body parts or lagging, I would say, would be my rear delt. So I always add a little something at the end of chest. So get about three sets of that, and yeah. All right, now. Two more sets. Oh. It feels good, not because I'm done, but because it gets me closer to where I want to be. As far as the show goes, it's me closer to the show. Every time I'm through, that's all I'm thinking. Another day. I'm trying to make it fun. I might not show it, you know, see a big smile, but I'm very happy. Satisfaction.
Almost finished, dude. No,
I don't do crystal light. I think it's all over promoted. And people are just lazy. No mind drinking the water. It's actually glutamine in there. I don't do Crystal Light, so it's just way too much NutraSweet, you know. And I count the NutraSweet that I eat. Usually, I might use it on my oatmeal. That's about it. But I don't believe in OD and NutraSweet. And plus, I believe Crystal Light is too addictive. It gets to a point where you can't stop drinking it. And it's like anything else, if I feel like I have no control, there's no need for it, because it's controlling you. You need to be in charge. It's bodybuilding, total charge. Couple of redux and cardio. Pulls down, no cardio. Can you do that out? Let's do this.
If you noticed, last year for the Road to the Olympia, I started over at my gym. My gym is no more because of many things that didn't work out as far as having money, people backing me up. You know, it's always a problem, people backing me up, you know, so. Whoever you usually see me with, they're the ones who are backing me up, you know, and it's just sad because it happened during the week of the Olympia, right before I got on the plane and left. I'm not quitting, just like the other shows I've done. It's just a mishap and you keep moving on. You can't mope on it. You know, I gave the neighborhood a chance. I gave myself a chance. And I look forward to giving myself another one, opening another gym in the near future.
Oh my God.